Hi Sagittarius, welcome to my channel, Advice to Think Twice. My name is Monica and I'm here with your weekly forecast for the week starting April 9th, 2018. Thank you very much for joining me. And as always, keep in mind, these are general energies, general readings that we're looking at, so that means it's not going to apply to everyone. Watch your moon and rising sign readings for additional messages that may apply to you. And just keep an open mind for the messages that come through, okay? So let's have a look at what's going on. At the bottom of the deck is your overall energy. We have the Knight of Pentacles. So with the Knight of Pentacles here, you're bound to see improvements. You're bound to see things moving forward, even if it's slowly, or even if you're just taking one step forward this week, but you are making progress, you are moving forward. This is also coming up with new plans, new strategies, starting a new path, maybe new training, new jobs coming up with this opportunity, okay, with this Knight of Pentacles energy. For others of you, this can be things moving forward with love. This could be someone coming back from your past with this energy, maybe Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, or Rising signs. It would be a situation where someone was previously emotionally unavailable, is what I want to say. Someone had their barriers up, okay, and it didn't work out. I feel that they're coming back and trying to work on it, okay? This could be you, or it could be someone coming to you, okay? So overriding energy, now this is your external influences, what may be meant to be, or where things are tending to go, external factors and all of that. We have the Wheel of Fortune, so this is a major arcana card. It talks about change, blessed change, the Wheel of Fate turning here, you being able to get what you deserve, okay? With the Wheel of Fortune, we may also see coming back around, okay, with this. So we may see cycles that we thought were over, they're coming back and trying to start again or start over with this energy. This can also talk about relocation. It can also talk about, you know, some sort of lucky strike for you. Traveling can also come up with the Wheel of Fortune here, and something to do with the month of October. So something that you dealt with last October, you may be looking at it again during this time. The underlying energy, and this is subtle energies, okay, subconscious energies. We have the Five of Rods. So this is also something that may be influencing your current situation that you may not be aware of, things happening behind the scenes. With the Five of Rods, this is an energy of healthy competition. This is an energy of wanting to do a lot of different things all at the same time. It can talk about, you know, split focus, but it's because you have a lot of different ideas and it's difficult to pinpoint the one that you're gonna work on, because you want to do a lot of things at the same time during this period. So with this, just be mindful. Don't let competition go too far. Don't let ego get the best of you. And if you are taking part in any sort of competition, make sure that you do everything above board, because again, you will get what you deserve. So anyone doing anything wrong, it will come back around and kind of hit them in the behind, okay? With the Five of Rods, can also talk about inner conflict or inner turmoil rather than conflict, okay, where you're a little bit agitated, you're not sure why, but you're just a little bit restless, okay, or you're feeling under pressure with this. So the energies of the week here, we have the Queen of Pentacles and the Nine of Cups. So I feel the first time, this can talk about earth sign energy coming back from your past. So Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Sun, Moon, or Rising signs. Again, either you're saying yes to this person coming back into your life or having a conversation with them, or this person is giving you the green light. This person is giving you a chance. This person's saying yes to you, okay? Now this can talk about big events. For some of you, this can talk about marriage proposals, or this talks about starting a family for some of you, or that's what's happening during this time, okay? And for others, the Queen of Pentacles can also indicate good news when it comes to your money situation or good news when it comes to your job. And again, the focus is you're starting something new at this time that can turn into something very successful for you in the long run. So it's just a matter of playing by the rules, doing everything right, okay, not skipping steps or cutting corners. We also have the Judgment card with the Three of Pentacles. So again, this is about getting the news that you wanted when it comes to a job situation, getting the news that you wanted when it comes to family situation. This can also talk about second chances, clean slates, someone wanting to work on the relationship or someone wanting to work on the partnership that you have, okay, the connection that you have here. This could also be second chances when it comes to your money. I feel that some debts may be forgiven, whether that's happening to you or you are forgiving someone else's debt, okay, but I feel like that's coming up as well. Or you're able to pay off a loan completely, or I think like student loans also comes up here, okay, and you're done, it's over. This is also getting the news that you were hoping for. Definitely to do with a job, okay, for a lot of you, or a living situation. And we do have the energy of family, pregnancy coming up here as well. For some of you, you might be trying to work things out with an ex because you have children together. Then we also have the Nine of Rods and the Eight of Swords. So again, this is someone being defensive, someone being a little bit cautious, okay, because again, something may have happened in the past where promises were not kept, or you've been burned too many times, okay, and this is a matter of, I'm willing to try again, I'm willing to give you a second chance, however, I'm not going to be the blind like I was in the past, okay, I'm going to keep my eyes wide open, I'm giving you a chance, however, I'm still protecting myself until I feel that it's safe to lower my guard a little bit, okay? Reconciliation after a long time of not speaking or not seeing each other can also be coming up. I feel that this is also about someone that has been away on military assignment. They finally get to come home. For some of you, that's also coming up here. So let's see what else we're getting. You may have some conflicting thoughts, or you may be defending your position to someone else, whether it's about, you know, giving someone a second chance and not everyone is happy with you for that. Because I do feel that you are ready to defend whatever you agree to. You're ready to defend it to other people. It may cause you to be a little bit, to keep to yourself a little bit, okay? It may be just one of them where you're not telling people about a decision that you've made until you see whether or not it's going to work out. And for others, this is actually either someone confronting you or you telling someone, hey, this is my decision, you have to respect it, okay? Something like that. Because not everyone is happy with the decisions that you're making. But at the end of the day, you have to do what's best for you. Obviously, take care of yourself, protect yourself, put your guard up. But if you feel you need to do something, then you have to give that a chance, okay, so that you don't have regrets further on. For those of you, this is, I feel like this is moving back into a place and you're starting to work on it and make it your own once again, or this is just moving together. For others, this is about joining your resources, you know, getting joint bank accounts and stuff like that, okay, and that's how you're actually moving forward with the relationship. It is a form of commitment you make to one another, okay, as well. For those of you, you may meet someone through work with this energy. I feel that you're a little bit apprehensive because it is work, But if it's, you know, meant to be energy, if this is a strong connection that you're feeling, you have to give it a chance, okay, really. And try to find a way to keep it from affecting your work. So let's look at your overall advice for the week. Okay. So we have alchemy. You have the Midas touch right now, and every project you begin turns to gold. So I do feel that for a lot of you, this talks about you're starting something new when it comes to making money, or your own business, or starting to work from home potentially, and that's why you're changing things around in your home. For those of you, I feel like this is talking about upping your security. If you have a website, or with sales, or with your personal information, or clients' information, or anything like that, I feel like you're upping your security. Whatever it is that you have been thinking of starting during this time, the message is absolutely go ahead. Make sure you have a little bit of a plan before you start, a little bit of a strategy, just like a general direction where, you know, what your ultimate goal is in the next few steps, and then just get going with it, okay? Nice and easy wins the race. Don't rush into anything, but you do have the potential to turn anything that you get involved with into a successful endeavor, whether that's with business or with your love life or whatever the case may be. You just have to take it nice and easy and do things the right way, okay? And that's how you ensure that you have a prolific future ahead of you, okay? But a good time for business can be a really good time for love. You just have to take charge of things and, you know, get the ball rolling, and create the change you want to see with this energy, okay? But you will have opportunities to show everyone that, to show everyone what you're made of, really, what you're capable of. So it's just a matter of knowing which opportunities to take. But it looks like a really good week, okay? Let me know how the cards apply for you if they do, and how your week is going. Thank you so much for joining me here. Watch your moon and rising sun readings, and I'll talk to you again very soon. Have a great week. Bye for now.